Michael Jackson placed his first as the most award-nominated artist of all time, as well as the highest-selling individual, and has during his 45-year-long career received 13 Grammy Awards, and currently holds 39 Guinness World Records. But looking at the pictures from him from 1979 and the ones from the mid-2000s, a clear change of appearance can be noticed. And the first thing that comes to mind, well, is surgery. Thus begging the question, why Michael Jackson underwent so much surgery? And that will be what I will be answering in this video, so stay tuned. Michael Joseph Jackson was born in Gary, Indiana on August 29, 1958 as the eighth child of Catherine Jackson and Joe Jackson. In 1964, at only 6 years of age, the young Michael would join the Jackson Brothers, a band formed and managed by his father. It included Michael as the lead singer and his brothers Jackie, Tito, Jermaine, and Brando as backup musicians. It was during the rehearsals of the song where Michael and his brothers experienced physical and emotional abuse from their father. In 1988, Michael wrote about this in his autobiography, Moonwalk, writing, "If you messed up, you got hit, sometimes with a switch, sometimes with a belt." He first publicly spoke about this in a 1993 interview with Oprah Winfrey, saying, "If you didn't do it the right way, he would tear you up, really get you." He was so afraid of his father, he would say, like, "There's been times he'd come to see me, I'd get sick, I'd start to regurgitate." He was also often teased and made fun of by Joe, with him telling Michael that he had a fat nose. Due to the immense pressure for him to succeed, Joe wouldn't let Michael spend time with his peers, leading to him having a lonely and isolated childhood. Michael's parents denied abusing him and argued that at the time, being whipping was considered as a form of disciplining a child. Joe would eventually admit that he did abuse Michael, and Michael would publicly forgive him, but for the sake of his father's image. Nonetheless, this period in his youth would leave a lasting effect and play a major role on his success as well as his physical changes. Back to 1964, and later that year the group is renamed into the Jackson 5, and would spend the next 4 years touring parts of the US, only to make a deal with the local Gary label called Steel Town Records in 1968. That same year they would release their first single called Big Boy, and would sign a new deal with Motown Records, relocating to Los Angeles. In 1970, I Want You Back became their first song to reach number one on the US Billboard charts, where it stayed for 4 weeks. In May of 1971, the Jackson moved to Encino, California, where Michael started his solo career, releasing 4 albums in a period of 3 years. Got to Be There and Ben were released in 1972, while Music and Me in 1973 and Forever Michael in 1975. In 1977, Michael moved to New York City to star as Scarecrow in the musical The Wiz. The film bombed, but he got the chance to explore the nightclubs, specifically Studio 54, where he was introduced to early hip-hop. The next year, he accidentally broke his nose during a dance routine and had his first rhinoplasty. He would have more to come due to the breathing difficulties brought by this one. By this time, Michael was only a teen icon, but that all changed with his 5th album, Off the Wall, being released in 1979. It reached number 3 on the US Billboard 200, selling over 20 million copies worldwide and establishing him as a solo artist. And the following year, he was awarded 3 American Music Awards for the best R&B vocal performance for Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. All the success, and Michael still wasn't satisfied, swearing he would surpass it with his next release. In late 1982, Michael Jackson released Thriller, his 6th studio album, which would go on to become the best-selling album of all time worldwide. Selling more than 70 million copies, it topped the Billboard 200 charts for 37 weeks straight. Thriller became the first album to produce 7 Billboard Hot 100 top 10 singles. On March 25, 1983, Michael reunited with the Jacksons for an NBC special titled Motown 25, Yesterday, Today, Forever. It aired on May 16th and was the first time Michael performed Billie Jean in his signature moonwalk dance on stage. It was seen by 47 million people and was compared to Elvis' Sullivan Show appearance due to the high view rate. At the 26th Annual Grammy Awards, Thriller won 8 awards in just one ceremony, setting a record only to be matched by the band Santana. It's 1983 and Pepsi had launched their New Generation campaign and had made a deal with Michael in November for $5 million. Michael suggested using a jingle version of Billie Jean for the commercial. But on January 27, 1984, during a simulated concert, pyrotechnics accidentally set Michael's hair on fire, causing second-degree burns to his scalp, after which he underwent treatment and had his third rhinoplasty. The issue was settled out of court, and Michael donated $1.5 million to Brodmann Medical Center, which changed its name into Michael Jackson Burns Center in his honor. The following year, he released the song We Are the World, earning $63 million, which all went to the poor of Africa and USA. The song also became one of the best-selling of all time, with over 20 million copies sold, and won him 4 Grammy Awards. 1987 came, and with it his first album in 5 years, the much-anticipated Bad. And like the one prior, it was a major success, becoming the first album to produce 5 US number 1 singles. Michael won the Award of Achievement in 1989, and Bad became the first album to top the charts of 25 countries and best-selling album worldwide in 1987 and 1988, with an estimated 30 to 40 million copies being sold. In 1988, he purchased 2,700 acres of land near Santa Ynez, California, and built a ranch fully equipped with a Ferris wheel, a carousel, movie theater, and a zoo. It was named the Neverland Ranch. Shortly after, he broke another record by becoming the first Westerner to appear in a commercial in the USSR. The public nicknamed him the King of Pop, which was embraced by his publicist. In 1986, Michael found himself bombarded with tabloid rumors and false allegations of bleaching his skin as a way to distance himself from the African-American community and to appear white. He publicly spoke about the matter, denying all allegations. They came from the fact that Michael had light brown skin, which noticeably got paler as he entered the 1980s. His dermatologist, Arnold Klein, diagnosed him with vitiligo, a disease that destroys the melanin cells in the skin and thus causes them to look paler. Michael was born with this, and as he got older, the condition worsened, causing white patches to appear all across his face and body, which he concealed using makeup, and by doing this, made his skin noticeable. In 1991, he released Dangerous, his 8th studio album, which was certified 8 times platinum in the US and had sold 32 million copies worldwide. By the end of 1992, it would go on to become the best-selling album worldwide. The same year, he founded Heal the World Foundation, bringing unprivileged children to the Neverland Ranch to use the theme park rides, and sent millions of dollars around to help children threatened by war, poverty, and disease. That same year, Michael visited the Ivory Coast, where he was crowned King Sani by a tribal chief, thus becoming royalty. In January of 1993, he performed at the Super Bowl 27th halftime in Pasadena, California, making it the first time ever halftime to draw a bigger audience than the actual game. In August of 1993, Michael was accused by the 13-year-old Jordan Chandler and his father. Jordan claimed that Michael had engaged in acts of kissing, masturbation, and oral sex. His mother initially told the police she didn't believe Michael had molested her son, but changed her position a few days later. Michael argued that he was a victim of a jealous father trying to exploit him for his money. Even his older sister, Latoya, accused him of being a pedophile, only to retract this later, claiming she had been forced into it by her abusive husband. Jordan Chandler gave the police a description of Michael's genitals, causing a strip search to be conducted. The jury felt the description did not match. In January the next year, Michael settled with the Chandlers out of court with a reported sum of $23 million. No criminal charges were pressed against Michael due to the lack of evidence. The investigation was officially closed on September 22, 1994. But during this time, Michael became dependent on painkillers as a way to cope with abuse allegations. That year, he proposed to Lisa Marie Presley, Elvis's daughter, and got married in La Vega, Dominican Republic in May of 1994. Less than a year and a half later, the two separated, citing irreconcilable differences. In June of 1995, Michael released the double album, His Story, Past, Present and Future, Book 1, consisting of two discs. The first one being the Greatest Hits album, and the second one containing 13 original songs and 2 cover songs. It debuted number 1 and sold 20 million copies, becoming the best-selling multi-disc album of all time. It received a Grammy Award nomination for Best Pop Vocal Performance of 1995. In 1996, he would win his second Grammy Award for Best Music Video for Scream. During the His Story World Tour, he would marry Debbie Rowe, his dermatologist assistant in Australia, resulting in 2 of his children, Michael Joseph Jackson Jr., also known as Prince, and Paris Michael Catherine Jackson. And like the previous one, this one was short-lasted as well, with the two divorcing in 1999 and Rowe conceding custody of the children, costing $8 million as settlement. From October of 1997 up to September 2001, Michael worked on Invincible, his 10th album, costing him $30 million to make. In June of 1999, he joined Luciano Pavarotti for a World Children Benefit Concert in Modena, Italy, which ended up raising $1 million for refugees of the Kosovo War and additional funds for the children of Guatemala. The next year, he would be recognized by Guinness World Records for supporting 39 charities, more than any other entertainer. On October 30, 2001, he released Invincible, his first full-length album in 6 years, and his last album of original content in his lifetime. At the beginning of May 2002, a documentary film crew led by Martin Bushin followed Michael for a couple of months, and it was broadcast in February of 2003 as Living with Michael Jackson. It showed Michael holding hands and discussing sleeping arrangements with the 12-year-old boy. He saw nothing wrong with having sleepovers with minors and sharing his bed with various people. These statements aroused suspicion. Michael insisted that the sleepover was not sexual and that his words had been misunderstood. December 18, 2003, Santa Barbara authorities charged Michael with 7 counts of child molestation and 2 counts of intoxicating a minor with alcoholic drinks. He denied all of the allegations and pleaded not guilty, thus beginning the People v. Jackson trial of January 31, 2005 in Santa Monica, California, which would last until the end of May. On June 13, 2005, Michael was acquitted on all counts, but the trial had taken a serious toll on his mental health and physical. Once this was over, he became reclusive and moved to Bahrain as a guest of Sheikh Abdullah. By 2006, Michael had accumulated a debt of $270 million, forcing him to use a piece of his ATV catalog stake, which was worth about $1 billion, as collateral to fight the debt. Bank of America then sold the loans to Fortress Investments, a company that buys distressed loans, and they provided Michael a new one of $300 million with reduced interest payments. By doing this, Sony Music would have the option of buying half of his stake, or about 25% as a set price. Michael's advisor suggested he shed a part of his stake to avoid going bankrupt. In November 15, 2006, he made his last public performance at the World Awards Music in London, where he sang We Are the World. In March 2009, he would announce a series of comeback concerts titled This Is It. These concerts were to be his first major concerts since His Story World Tour of 1997, after which he planned of retiring. The plan was 10 concerts in London, followed by Paris, New York City, and finally Mumbai. And these concerts were supposed to run from July 13, 2009 to March 6, 2010. Over 1 million tickets were sold in less than just 2 hours, and the hype was real. On June 25, 2009, paramedics found Michael in an unresponsive state, after which resurrection attempts were performed. They proved unfruitful, and Michael was pronounced dead at 2:26 p.m. His death was ruled a homicide, caused by propofol and benzodiazepine overdose. His physician, Conrad Murray, was charged with involuntary manslaughter and got 4 years in prison. The memorial service was held on July 7, 2009, at the Staples Center in Los Angeles, and became the most watched in streaming history with 31.1 million Americans alone, and a worldwide audience ranging from 2.5 to 3 billion. As for the child abuse allegations, the FBI released files on Michael on December 2009, revealing its role in the two trials. The FBI found no evidence of criminal conduct on Michael's behalf. It is estimated that Michael Jackson had over 100 surgeries done on his face before his death. Based on my research for this video, I've come to the conclusion that the reason behind this is his father's neglectful and rough way of disciplining him early on in his youth, creating a sense of insecurity and self-hate. Michael then wished not to look like his father and found plastic surgery as a way to cope with this unresolved childhood trauma. By changing his appearance, he could in a way distance and disassociate himself with Joe Jackson, his father. Nevertheless, Joe played a major role in developing Michael as a person,